Hi, before we get started, just a quick word on formatting in Excel. So when we apply formatting in Excel, it is just that, a format, kind of like using bold or italics, only the appearance of the cell contents will be affected. So the methods we're about to go over in this tutorial will not change the values in your spreadsheet. They will only make those values look like phone numbers. So let's take a look at some examples. Excel comes with a few phone formats preloaded. So selecting and applying this is probably the most common way to apply phone formatting. So to do this, select the cells you want to apply the phone formatting to, right click and select Format Cells. Make sure you're in the Number tab of the Format Cells window, and under Category, look for special. From the option type, select phone number, and you can preview what this will look like right here in the sample box. And if you're happy with it, click OK. So let's open this window again for a moment. So the default phone format in your system is going to depend on your local settings and what is typical in your region. So for example, mine is set to English United States and applies the conventional format used here in the US, which is the area code in parentheses and then a dash in the middle after the third number. But if you need to use a phone format that is traditional in a country different than the one you're in, you'll need to change the locale from this dropdown. And FYI, not all the locations in the dropdown list will have a phone format preloaded. So if you come across one of these, you'll need to find a different one on the list. And I wish I had a shortcut for you here, but really you just have to keep searching through the list. For example, if I were to select French Belgium from this list of locations, notice how I have no formats to choose from. But if I scroll just a little bit more and select French France, I have more options to choose from. So the default for this region is labeled, and excuse my pronunciation, numéro de téléphone. And you can see up here in the sample box how it would change our phone number formatting. Let's go back in here for a minute. But there are also all these other options for other French-speaking regions, including one for French Belgique, which we didn't have formatting for a moment ago when we selected French Belgium. But what if you still can't find a phone format that you want to use? So if this happens to you, you can always create your own. And FYI, there are so many ways that you can format phone number values. So the examples that we're about to go over are meant to give you an idea of how you can use the custom formatting tool to begin creating your own phone format. So, okay, let's say that we want to create a custom phone format that uses dashes or spaces. So we would select the cells that we want to apply the phone formatting to, right click, and again, select Format Cells, making sure we're in the Number tab of the Format Cells window. This time we'll go to Custom, and here in the Type box, where it says General, we'll type the phone format that we want to use exactly as we want for it to appear. And to do this, we can use either zero or the hashtag symbol to represent each value. So let's say we want to use dashes first. So we can type 000 dash, three zeros, and then four zeros in the end. And you can preview what it will look like here in the sample window. And once you're happy with it, click OK to apply your custom formatting. So likewise, if we want to use spaces instead of dashes, and again, remember that you can use either hashtags or zero, we could type three hashtags for the area code, three hashtags for the first three numbers, followed by four hashtags in the end, and click OK. Also, if you need to include a plus one or other country code at the beginning of your phone format, you can do that here too by including it as you create your custom format. just type plus one at the beginning of your entry and click OK. Quick side note about the custom category. So this category will already contain a variety of formats for you to choose from, but also any custom formats that you create, so phone format or something else, will also be stored here so you can use it later. And this is going to apply just to the computer that you use to create the format. So using periods in phone formatting instead of dashes or spaces is pretty common. However, it's a little trickier to format than dashes or spaces because Excel sees the period as a decimal point and insists on placing it at the end of all the numbers. Take a look at what happens here. Let's select the cells we want to format. Again, we'll go into Format Cells, select Custom, and if we were to try to use a period where we use dashes or spaces before, notice what happens here in the sample box. All of the periods and zeros are added at the end of what should be our phone number. So to work around this, we need to use an escape character, and you can use either quotation marks or a backslash. So let's delete this and we'll use a backslash. And so we could do 000 backslash, then the period. And notice now in the sample box how it's formatting with the periods the way that we want it to. And once we're done, we click OK. And we have our phone numbers formatted with periods. Thanks for watching. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.